Canucks and the Stars from American Airlines Center, Dallas, celebrating 20 years of the franchise being in this city, and tonight honoring one of the team's greats, goaltender Marty Turco.
Are you kidding me?
Marty Turco. His game was the embodiment of swagger and bravado. He made the simple save look stylish and the larcenous save with an ostentatious flair. His success between the pipes translated directly to the record books. Games played, wins, save percentage, shutouts, the list goes on. He was an elite franchise goaltender who took pride in the community. Marty chaired numerous causes for the Dallas Stars Foundation and made an effort to connect with kids in the Metroplex. Dr. Pepper and the Dallas Stars congratulate Marty Turco on being named to the 20th anniversary team.
Fans, you voted for the greatest players in franchise history, and we're proud to introduce, as a member of our 20th anniversary team, the one, the only, goaltender Marty Turco! At this time, we'd like the team captains at center ice for the honorary puck drop. Team captains to center ice, please.
Who can forget that four overtime goal that Henrik Sedin scored against Marty Turco in the playoffs of 07? What a series that was. Turco had three shutouts and still lost in that goaltending seven-game duel with Vancouver's Roberto Luongo. Tonight it's Schneider against Nielstorp, and the Canucks start Kevin Bieksa, who is reunited with Dan Hamhuisa on defense. Bieksa, the big goal that earned the Canucks a single point in Chicago two nights ago. And Jaromír Jágr starts the game for the Dallas Stars. He took a puck in the posterior at practice this morning. Had to leave for a bit, but was able to regroup and continue the morning skate. And we'll play this game on a line with Jamie Benn and Brendan Morrow. We're set to go. Ryan Kessler's unit begins this game for the Canucks. Zach Cassian on the right in the absence of Yannick Hansen, who serves his one-game suspension. And we're underway with Aaron Rome sending the puck into the Vancouver zone. Hamhuisa reverses for Bieksa, shoots the puck around. Jágr's there to intercept. Higgins fighting for the puck for Vancouver. And it comes to Jágr. Blue line feed, Alex Goligoski. Now it's centered. Jágr shoots, and an early stop for Schneider, who fought that shot off and denied the Stars a goal 20 seconds into the game. Kessler can't get the puck past Rome. Here's Benn in front on the backhand. Couldn't get a shot away. Now he gets the puck again. Scores! A horrible start for the Canucks, hemmed in their own zone. And 35 seconds in, Benn makes it 1-0.
Well, we saw Tuesday in Chicago, the one-on-one play by the Vancouver Canucks was not very good. And here's Kevin Bieksa goes charging out. Benn goes around him. Dan Hamhuisa goes down. Benn goes around him. And then he beats Corey Schneider from a bad angle over the shoulder. Both defensemen guessing on this one. That's after Benn had beaten Kevin Bieksa. He beats Dan Hamhuisa, able to pull it out, and from an almost impossible angle beats Corey Schneider over the shoulder.
There go the keys to the game as Alex Burrows tips the puck out to center. Early goal for Dallas.
And both of them.
I said, he was very prominent in that shift, wasn't he? By the way, we should mention, when we say Benn getting the goal, it was Jamie Benn, because there are two Benns in the lineup tonight. Jordy's on defense for Dallas in the absence of Trevor Daly. Alex Burrows bringing the puck in. Stars take it away. And Robida passes near side to Brendan Dillon, hero of the game last week at Rogers Arena. Schneider out of his net, almost got caught there by Antoine Roussel. Mason Raymond collects the puck and sends it ahead to David Booth. Booth playing the off wing tonight on the line with Schrader and Raymond. Philip Larson back for the puck, gets it around. And the Stars start out. Cody Eakin across to Jordy Benn, He tips the puck free. Philip Larson sends it forward. Ballard passes over to Jason Garrison.
Jordy Benn has been in and out of the lineup. He has played 8 games already.
Just called back up. Schrader after the puck inside the Dallas blue line. Comes to him on the right wing. Jordan Schrader turning in the corner. Behind the net to Raymond. Mason Raymond works his way to the far side. Passes back to the blue line. Just held in, but intercepted. And Benn flips the puck out to center. Here's Bieksa with room. Tips the puck in on the right side. He and Larson both go down. Rome back for the puck, hit by the other Aaron Volpatti. Back in the lineup for Vancouver. Volpatti, who sat out in Chicago, hoping to get that pass in front, but the puck got by him, and it slides down on Corey Schneider. Bieksa circles his net. Pass ahead to Aaron Volpatti, who turns and fires forward, but right to Aaron Rome. Eric Nystrom plays the puck in. That took a funny hop right towards Jamie Benn. He and Volpatti fight for the puck. Hanhuis gets it. And across to Dale Weiss. Weiss through center on the right wing. Tips the puck into Dallas territory and starts a line change for Vancouver. Here's Jamie Benn as we hit the 3-minute mark. Jagr's in on the right wing. Puts on the brakes. Lost control of the puck, but Benn's in to pick it up in the corner. Pass back. Goligoski. Long wrist shot. And that deflected wide of the goal. Tanev takes a hard hit as he plays the puck around, but Kessler has it. Edler back to Kessler on the right wing. Kessler with a wrist shot, and that's over top of the net. And the Stars break back. Chance for a 2-on-1. Jagr with Morrow. Jagr in front. Jagr shoots and blocked by Tanev. Morrow from the corner. Jagr works his way out the far side. Cycles for Brendan Morrow. Derek Roy behind the net. Checked there by Chris Higgins. And Higgins makes a nice play ahead to Ryan Kessler. Kessler lead feed. Kassian onside. No! Wow, one linesman said okay. And the other called it offside. And I actually think that the whistle was the right call.
I agree. The linesman who was on the line made the call. You can see there's a lineman who was on the line making the call. The other linesman's waving it off. Here Jamie Benn goes around Kevin Bieksa. Goes around Dan Hanhuis. And Corey Schneider is being bothered a little bit by Jagr. And just never gets his shoulder over square. And Chris Tanev, who has been much better at angling his body away from hits like that, takes one from Brendan Morrow.
Discussion about where the faceoff's going to be. Originally, they brought it down into the Vancouver zone, and now they'll face off outside the Canuck blue line, where the pass originated. Bank pass off the boards. Or maybe they're saying the Stars tipped it in the neutral zone. That's putting Kassian offside. Riley Smith, who scored his first career goal in that game at Rogers Arena, fighting to hold the puck in. It's out to center. Henrik Sedin picks it up. Sends Burrows in on the left wing. Daniel going to the net. Burrows with a wrist shot. Stopped by Nilsdorp, and the rebound taken away by Stefan Robida. He gets the puck ahead to Louis Erickson. Now to center to Smith. Dylan racing to join him. He's open in the middle as two Canucks went to the puck carrier, but the pass was never made, and here comes Burrows in transition. Burrows drops for Henrik Sedin. Henrik waiting for help. Passes back to Keith Ballard. In deep for Henrik. Rome tips the puck away from him. Dylan bumps Henrik Sedin. Garrison tries a shot. That hits Burrows behind the net. Henrik picks up the puck. Centering pass picked off by Cody Eakin, and he sends Smith away. Erickson dumps the puck in from center and heads to the bench. Ballard back for it. Reverses. Right to Roussel. Tried to center the puck. Blocked by Garrison. And Schrader makes the outlet to Mason Raymond. Up ahead for David Booth. Tips the puck to the corner, Rome back for it. Hanhuis on the far side, moves down from the left point. Puck reversed by Dallas. Goligoski finds his man, and Eakin's able to get the puck out. A little over 5 minutes into the first. Stars got their opening goal and the opening minute from Jamie Benn. Booth after the loose puck, Stars clear at the center. Edler. Pardon me, Raymond to Bieksa. And he hammers one in wide of the Dallas goal. Here's Philip Larson to Vern Fiddler. Eric Nystrom plays the puck in, and Ryan Garbutt gets to it first, sends it up the middle. Here's Jordy Benn. Tried to send one on goal, reaching in with Zach Kassian to deflect that puck out of play. Here's Dan Murphy.
Don't forget about Safeway's $1 million score and win. If any Vancouver player scores 5 goals in tonight's game, Alan Walters of Penticton could win $1 million. Shop and swipe your club card and you could be our next lucky winner.
Any complaints about the broadcast? You know where to send them, at Sportsnet Murph on Twitter.
Yes, don't be sending them to my Twitter account.
Your phone is so hard to manipulate. You need to get a new phone from our friends at Rogers.
Yes,
Jones.
I do need that.
The dial doesn't work anymore. Here's Fiddler trying to move in. Nystrom takes his pass. First shot blocked away by Schneider. Volpatti after the loose puck. Here's Max Lapierre. Sends the puck in from center. And heads to the bench for Vancouver. Kassian was out on that shift to the fourth line, and now Weiss has come on with Kessler and Higgins, so Alain Vigneault not wasting any time making a switch here. Kassian and Dale Weiss. Garrison digging for the puck deep in his own zone, tips it around. Higgins beaten to the puck by Robida, who overskated it, and Higgins pokes it ahead to Ryan Kessler. He backhands onto the right wing for Weiss to chase after. Dale Weiss takes a puck from Dillon as he plays the puck around. Jamie Benn gets it ahead. And here's Jaromir Jagr. Shovels the puck for Benn at center. He sidesteps Weiss and moves in. Benn leaves for Morrow. Tried to center for Benn. That was knocked away. Benn again to Jagr, who had to reach awkwardly trying to get a shot away. And he just wound up chipping the puck to the corner. Kessler checked by Goligoski. And onto the puck is Aaron Rome, who drew an assist on the game's only goal. Roy is in with a wrist shot, gloved by Schneider. And Corey Schneider, who was beaten early, hangs on to that one. Just over 7 minutes in, and Dallas, the home team, with the lead.
Manson deserved the penalty on the play in Chicago. Today didn't have much to say other than he had a chuckle at the video explanation from Brendan Shanahan. He does feel, when we look at the video, is that there's no way that Hansen, once he's reaching up for the puck, can identify right away that's Hossa and that he's going to deliver a blow to the back of the head on purpose. He doesn't think there was enough time to make that reaction once he decided to go up for the puck. He's not happy with the suspension, but of course there's nothing they can do now.
Well, John, there wasn't even going to be a penalty call. The Canucks played the puck for about 5 seconds after it, and then after the fact, Yannick Hansen got the roughing penalty.
Aaron Volpatti taking Hansen's spot in the lineup tonight. Here's Mason Raymond on the left wing, trying to send one in front for Jordan Schrader. He works the puck to Raymond on the left wing, but it's tipped past him to Louis Erickson. Erickson slides the puck gently into the Vancouver zone. David Booth goes back and banks it around to Kevin Bieksa. Ahead to Jordan Schrader. Now for Raymond, who's chasing after the puck on Philip Larson. Larson plays it away. It's out to center onto the stick of Derek Roy. And a penalty coming up to Dallas for interference. Yes. Riley Smith got tangled up with one of the Canucks, and Vancouver will get a power play.
Riley Smith coming across, clipped Kevin Bieksa. Referee right there to make the call. Surely Riley Smith is thinking, okay, that's just I had my back to the play, but he did run into Kevin Bieksa and ends up in the penalty box.
Canucks power play, 3 for 7 the last two games, and is up to 10th in the NHL rankings. It's just over 19%. Here's one chance in front, and Daniel passing off for Kessler, who wasn't anywhere near where the puck went. Canucks regain control. They'll try again. Daniel on the left side. Brings the puck around for Henrik Sedin. Henrik puts it on the forehand, passes back to Edler. Other side, Kessler. Back to Edler. One-timer blocked by Fiddler. Kessler gets the puck again. Back to Edler. Over to Henrik. Down low. Centering pass off the post as Daniel was set up by Alex Burrows. Another shot by Edler. Scores! Burrows was in front. Screening at the very least. And on the power play, the Canucks tie the game at 1.
Boy, and talk about great puck movement. The Canucks, once they gained the zone, had complete control. Henrik and Daniel again, making sure that there's no way the Dallas penalty killers could get involved. Alex Burrows sets up Daniel. That one's off the crossbar. What a play that was. And then Kessler to, I think Alex Burrows tips that one. The long wrist shot, get the shot through. And we saw Alex Edler in Chicago do the same thing, get the puck in the middle. He wired the one in Chicago. This one, a little wrist shot, and I think Alex Burrows tips it by.
We will await the official announcement, but what we do know is at 8:29 of the first period, the Canucks have righted the ship after a horrendous start on the opening shift, and it's a 1-1 tie. Now Booth is in on the right wing. David Booth stops behind the goal, finds some room coming out, puts the puck in front for LaPierre. That's knocked away. And here comes Cody Eakin with a pass for Antoine Roussel. Comes back to Eakin, and Schneider had to be sharp to make that stop. Booth gets the puck out. LaPierre trying to move past Aaron Rome. The veteran of 148 games in a Vancouver uniform, Aaron Rome now wearing number 27 for the Dallas Stars. Alex Goligoski ahead for Brendan Morrow. The Dallas captain tips the puck in. Indeed for Jagr. Here's Morrow. Back to Dillon. His shot kicked up by the right pad of Corey Schneider. They're crediting Edler with the goal.
I think it's Alex Burrows.
Always room to change. Sedin line onto the ice. Garrison's in deep. Pass to Henrik. Centering feed. And Daniel going to the net. Couldn't make contact. Jagr gets the puck and chips it out. Brought back in by Dale Weiss. Nice move to the line. Works the puck to Henrik Sedin. Centering pass for Weiss. And that was intercepted by Brendan Dillon. Ben slowly to center. Plays the puck in and heads off. Dan Hamhuis. Pass to the far side. Higgins quickly the other way to Kessler. Cuts wide. Kessler round the net. Out the other side. Center and pass deflects to Hamhuis, who tried a shot. Higgins on a rebound. A swing and a miss. The exit center check by Roy. In with Erickson. Offside. On a close play at the line, but Louis Erickson just ahead of the play. Did he tip it? Did he not? Alex Burrows might have got a piece of that one on a shot by Edler that tied the game.
Do you know a child that's enrolled in hockey and exemplifies qualities of leadership and teamwork? Go to Canucks.com/safeandfun to nominate them to be a Chevrolet Safe and Fun Hockey Ambassador.
Oh, there's Alex Edler took the shot from the point, and Alex Burrows in front of the net. And you can see off the heel of Alex Burrows' stick, off the post and in. And the two goals in Chicago, Burrows provided the screen. That time he provided the tip.
Still not his goal, but if my esteemed partner has his way,
yes,
they will award it to Alex Burrows.
They were watching our trucks work.
Erickson to the blue line. Larson down to Roy. He shovels the puck in for Erickson. Bieksa breaks that up. And the puck sent near side to Zach Cassian, who continues on. And a fourth line spot. Oh, Bieksa stuck the leg out, it looked like, on Erickson. And he'll get a tripping penalty.
Well, he's going to get a kneeing penalty.
And Erickson, a little slow as he heads to the Dallas bench. It's an instinctive reaction sometimes when you know somebody's gotten by you.
Well, Kevin was charging out. Erickson was going the other way, and Kevin Bieksa gets two for kneeing. Here's a pass to Erickson. He's going one way and Kevin's coming the other way.
Power play for the Dallas Stars at 10:53. Certainly leg-to-leg contact, but on further review, there was no real egregious stretching out of the left leg. But the Stars to the power play. And they set it up in the Vancouver zone. Ben, the goal scorer. Down low to Jagr. Up to Jamie Benn. Jagr again to Benn. Morrow's in front. Tanev Sprawl. Playing where Bieksa likely would in a penalty-killing role. Puck held into the blue line by Robida. Takes a return pass. Long shot blocked by Tanev, who's having an excellent penalty-killing shift. And Burrows is able to clear the puck down the ice.
And that's such a big advantage for Chris Tanev to play 30 games with the Chicago Wolves and be in every situation. He was the key defenseman for the Wolves and did everything. Now he's killing penalties with the Canucks.
LaPierre killing some time before banking the puck down into the Dallas zone. Penalty's just about half over. Bieksa off. Just over 8 minutes left. First period. And the Stars yet to register a shot through to Corey Schneider on this power play. Goligoski at the left point. Tips the puck in. Erickson's back out there, so that's good news for the Dallas Stars. Up front with Ryder and Roy. Intercepting is Higgins. Three Canucks through center. Higgins into the middle. Garrison dishes off on a wrist shot stopped by Nilsdorf as he was tested by Maxime LaPierre. Larson just onside, tips the puck to the corner. Cam Hughes leads for Tanev, who delayed but then couldn't get the pass through. Cam Hughes comes back to help him out. Gets the puck ahead for Raymond. Larson plays it in deep again. Schneider settles the puck for Tanev, who sends it off the boards and ahead. Held in as Weiss couldn't get it by Goligoski. Goligoski at the left point. Across to Larson. The X is standing in the box. Penalty's now over. Stars still controlling. Goligoski at the left point. Bieksa comes and checks him from behind. Gets the puck ahead for Raymond to chase after, trying to get behind the Dallas defense, but the Stars able to come back and break it up. Under 7 minutes to go, first period. Ryan Garbutt tips the puck in. Fiddler after it through the crease and out the near side onto the stick of Henrik Sedin, who headmans to Daniel. Into the middle. Edler had joined the rush. That didn't work, and Daniel retreats to his own blue line. Gets the puck ahead to Burrows. Drops it back for Edler. And now Keith Ballard controls in his own zone. Pass for Edler was off the mark. He's used to sending it to the right-hander.
Chris Tanev with the penalty-killing duties. That's why he's not out there.
So Edler had another shift there on the right side for a little bit. Here's Roussellin on the left wing with a wrist shot. Schneider able to squeeze it, hang on. He's faced seven shots so far. The first one beat him, but none since. A 1-1 tie.
Well, for a sneak peek on Rudy's road to stardom, why don't you pick up an issue of Sportsnet magazine? It's on newsstands now.
Trade deadline day today in the NBA.
Mm.
I know you were very concerned.
I had fleeting interest. Loose puck in the Dallas zone. The American Airlines Center where the Mavericks and Magic played last night.
One of your personal friends moving on to Milwaukee.
J.J. Redick. Here's a chance for Garrison, and through a screen he was stopped by Christopher Nilsdorf. David Booth trying to power his way out front. Puck winds up on the stick of Jaromir Jagr. Tried to thread it through for Ben. That was blocked, and Garrison, who made the play, sends the puck around. Ballard to Burrows. Ahead for Raymond, knocked away by Jordy Benn. Our Victoria viewership should spike here in this game.
Yes.
Both Benn brothers in the Dallas lineup. Jamie's after the puck, checked by the other number 14, Alex Burrows. Canucks tried to get the puck to Henrik Sedin at center. That was cut off by Jordy Benn. And he now controls the puck. Gives it away to Garrison. Lead pass off the skate of Henrik Sedin, who now is able to work the puck to brother Daniel. Jordy Benn back for it, up the boards. Edler cuts that off. Here's Henrik Sedin. In deep for Zach Kassian. Kassian out the near side. Down for Henrik. In deep for Daniel. Swings the puck in front, just out of the reach of Kassian going to the net. Henrik from behind the goal. Kassian goes to the front once more. Daniel's there as well. He's tripped up. Dillon got the leg out on him. And that went undetected by the referees. Tanev trying to hold the puck into the blue line. Does. Brendan Dillon there to intercept in front of his net. And passes the puck over to Derek Roy. Up the middle to Riley Smith. And he backhands the puck deep into the Vancouver zone. Here's young Chris Tanev ahead to Zach Kassian. Drops for Max LaPierre. He finds some room on the left side. LaPierre across. Volpatti shoots. Stopped by Nilstorp, who hangs on for the whistle. Good puck movement there from the fourth line.
It just took a little too long for Aaron Volpatti to let that one go. He took the puck, and then he teed it up. And that gave the goaltender lots of time to come across. A good hard pass by Max LaPierre. There's no way it was going to get picked off, but Volpatti couldn't handle it cleanly. And Nilstorp comes across and makes an easy save.
Kessler, Higgins, and Weiss back out for Vancouver.
Christopher Nilstorp has had a goals against of just barely over two his last 2 years in Sweden. A little older, they wanted some reliable guy to back up Carey Lehtinen.
There's your double wave.
There is your double wave out right there.
Uncalled. And a Bieksa one-time attempt set up by Hanhuis's off a stick and wide. Allow me to reiterate, I don't like the idea of giving a team a penalty for double wave out, but it's still in the rule book, isn't it?
Yes.
It's been years. Here's Weiss down the right wing, sending one on goal. Stick save, Nilstorp. Weiss again from the corner, behind the net to Ryan Kessler. He's checked by Eric Nystrom, and the puck is sent ahead to Ryan Garbutt, who banks it into the Vancouver zone. Bieksa frees the puck up for Hanhuis. Good job by Higgins to lift the stick of Nystrom, who is about to intercept that puck. Canucks in the middle of a change as Garbutt carries in over the Vancouver line. Wrist shot attempt blocked by Bieksa, who gathers the puck and passes around for Dan Hanhuis. Hanhuis delays, now fires onto the right wing. Mason Raymond poke check of the blue line. Stars trying to take advantage of that, but Eakins passes off the mark and Garrison has the puck. Ballard nicely ahead to Jordan Schrader. And a beautiful pass to David Booth, who lets go with a wrist shot off the blocker of Nilstorp. Raymond after the rebound, played away from him by Jordy Benn, and then Raymond tripped Benn. There'll be a Vancouver penalty. Play continues, and bringing the puck out is Michael Ryder. Nilstorp to the bench for the extra attacker. Ryder in on the right wing. Michael Ryder drag move and a wrist shot blocked. And there's the whistle for the tripping penalty to Mason Raymond.
And this is one of those where L.A. and Vigneault will look at it and say, come on, Mason. Puck was already gone. Jordy Benn was by him. And Mason Raymond just sticks the stick out and takes the tripping penalty. And that's 200 feet away from your own net.
Power play comes with just over 2 minutes to go in the first period. Stars didn't get a sniff on their first man advantage.
Matter of fact, the Canucks had the best scoring chance.
Stars 0 for their last 8 with the power play tonight and 7 in the previous 2 games. Burrows against Jamie Benn, who won the puck back cleanly, but right up the middle and down to the Dallas zone. Stefan Robida, pass to center. Benn steps around Kessler, steps around another man, Burrows, before letting go with a wrist shot that's deflected over the glass for a whistle.
And you can see most players with power play goals, and that's teams that switch it around. I think more than anything else, if you use three lines, and the Dallas Stars do, Jaromir Jagr is the one constant, you switch the guys around, you're going to have multi-players with power play goals.
Hanhuis checked behind his own net. Jagr after the puck, Canucks win it back, and it's sent all the way down behind the Dallas goal. Canucks have had the last 4 shots in the hockey game. They're 7 apiece. Dallas with a minute 20 to go in the penalty to Mason Raymond. And another good job by the tandem of Hanhuis and Bieksa, who have lots of experience playing together, and it showed there. Stars with a sloppy changer. They now have the personnel they desire on the ice, and Goligoski brings the puck through center. Pass, Erickson, off the heel of his stick. Ballard quickly onto the loose puck, gets it around. Nice hold by Goligoski. Down into the corner, Roy centers, and a right pass saved by Schneider on a one-time attempt. Ryder wasted no time shooting that puck.
1 minute remaining in the first
final
period.
Minute, first period, 40 seconds to go in the power play. Larson just holds the line. But Garrison has time to send it up the glass and hit Goligoski, and the puck stays in the Vancouver zone. He puts it in front over the stick of Kessler. Here's Ryder. A little sloppy. Larson at the left point, fighting the puck, but settles it and moves down into the corner. Passes back to Ryder. Michael Ryder with a slap shot, blocked by Ryan Kessler. Ballard gets the loose puck, shoots it around, past Goligoski and down with just 10 seconds to go in the penalty to Mason Raymond. Hey, Ryder. Stars power play comes to an end. Dallas 0-2 with a man advantage, and the game still tied at 1. They managed just that one shot, but Schneider had to be sharp with the right leg. Now the puck squirts in front. Schneider tips it away. Canucks can't get it out. Time running out on the first period. Stars trying to set up one last shot, but they're going to run out of time as the puck is thrown in front and intercepted by Raymond. So a tough first shift for the Canucks, but Alex Edler credited with a power play goal for Vancouver. Tied it up. We'll hear from Alex Edler in just a couple of moments. Also a panel of Brad Fay, Brad May, and Mike Keenan. Who better than Mike Keenan to tell us what he would do with the Luongo-Schneider situation? That's coming up. This game's tied at 1-1.
Welcome back to Dallas. Second period just about to get underway between the Canucks and Stars. This game is all knotted at one. Second time these two teams have played in the last week. Now there's Brendan Dillon, the hero from last Friday's game in Vancouver. He's got 3 goals on his young career, but he's calling this one against the Canucks his biggest so far. Of course, it was the winner late in the third. He was a big Canucks fan not too long ago, celebrated during the Canucks run to the Cup Final. He was downtown watching the big screens, and no, he didn't bust any mirrors, but he says he still has a Burrow poster on his wall, guys.
Oh, there is Alex Burrows. And John, we had unexpected curious visitors in the first intermission.
Yes, we are the broadcaster of record in this one, and I thought the guys in the truck did a great job with showing how this one does change direction. Alex Burrows in front, and this is the angle that sold the people here at American Airlines Arena that it did change. The goaltender is playing it off his body, and Alex Burrows tips it off the post and in, and he gets credit for the goal.
So Burrows from Edler and Kessler, and as always, that means a winner on Safeway Score and Win. For Safeway and Quaker Chewy Bars, we congratulate a woman who swiped a free club card from Prince Rupert, Loretta Pallister, and by doing that, you've won yourself a Hoover Wind Tunnel air vacuum, Loretta.
And talking to Murph, Alex Edler said Alex Burrows has provided such great screens, and you think to those last two goals in Chicago, John, where Alex Burrows was standing right in front of Ray Emery. He didn't get an assist. Never showed up on the scoreboard, but was directly responsible for both those goals.
Underway, period 2. And Burrows with a pass across to Daniel Sedin. To the blue line. Tanev just held it onside. Real close play. Puck thrown towards the goal. Daniel after it behind the net. Derek Roy takes possession for the Stars and chips the puck to center. It's by Tanev. Schneider's going to have to play it. And he backhands the puck over to Edler. Couldn't get it by to Louis Erickson. Hendrick Sedin. Across to Daniel Sedin. Who gains the red and tips the puck in before heading to the bench. Burrows carries on and throws a hit along the end boards. Riley Smith comes away with the puck, gets it ahead. Nice hold by Higgins. Here's Burrows. Oh, man, wow. That looked like they held it onside. Derek Amell blowing play down.
Here's Alex Burrows against Chicago Blackhawks. Right in front of Ray Emery. The shot in Kevin Bieksa's shot again with Alex Burrows standing right in front. And here's the Alex Edler one from this game, tipped in by Alex Burrows past Christopher Nilstrup. Nilstort. I'll get used to it.
We're getting there. Whether that puck was in or just barely out, his Bieksa breaks it off the draw with a drop pass. Higgins with a shot, handled by Nilstort. Derek Amell was the man who blew it down, and he had the Matt Duchene kerfuffle in Denver the other night, but this was a very close play at the line, and either way, it was a tough one to make. That one not as tough.
It surprises me that the officials aren't allowed to confer on a blown offside call. It's not one of those they can get together on. I would think that that would be almost an automatic.
Well, you seem to have numbers for everyone.
Yes, I do.
You should get to the bottom of this.
I should.
Kevin Bieksa wrists the puck in from center. Nielstorp leads for Aaron Rome, who tried to send it around. That was blocked by Kessler. Goligoski bodied behind the net. Kessler after the puck. He was tied up, and here's Jamie Benn. Ahead to Brendan Morrow. Goligoski drives the puck in from center. Schneider tried to cut it off, couldn't. Hand use reverses for Bieksa. And he just lifts the puck high and out to center. Glove down by Jordy Benn. Must have been touched by a stick in between. As Yager's able to break it. Round behind the net. Now tries to shovel the puck back, but in the way was Dale Weiss, who slides the puck over to Chris Higgins. Canucks changing as Higgins sends the puck in. Roussel hoping for a long pass and just a little too impatient as he got in over the blue line a millisecond before the puck was on his stick.
Jaromir Jagr is one of those guys. He just turned 41 last week when he was in Vancouver, and keeps himself in better shape now than he did when he was early in his career in Pittsburgh. Four times he's been over 20 minutes. He was over 20 minutes in Vancouver the other night.
Canucks off the draw. Go to work in the Dallas zone. Mason Raymond up the boards to Jordan Schrader. Nice pass to Raymond. Raymond finds some room. Fakes the shot. Lets it go. Blocked by Roussel. Ballard with a spin move on the right wing. Hooks the puck back to Raymond. Raymond towards the goal. Booth in front. Kicking in the puck. Still loose. And the Star is able to clear it to Michael Ryder. Eakin for Dallas, across for Jordy Benn. He lost the puck in his skates. Alone in front is Booth. He shoots, kicked out by the left pad of Nielstorp. Stars the other way. Roussel in front. Ryder on the backhand. Scores! Broken play as the puck deflected to Ryder. And he's able to give Dallas a second lead of the night.
I'll give Michael Ryder credit, too. He didn't just shoot this one as soon as he got it. He waited and on the backhand, slid it through. Here's the shot. It's off a stick right over to Michael Ryder. Pull. Gets it to his backhand and slides it by a screen. Corey Schneider. Everybody's back. Four guys back for the Canucks, but they can't get to this one. And Jason Garrison's there. Keith Ballard's there. Ryder's still able to slide it through.
Ryder has his fifth of the season, but it's only his second goal in the last 12 games. And it came on the heels of a glorious chance for David Booth on the turnover by Jordy Benn. Stars up 2-1. Puck sent into Vancouver's zone. Garbutt gets there first and play continues. Chris Tanev. Round for Alex Edlund. Quickly to the far side. Cassian put the puck in the middle and the Stars intercept. It's thrown in front. Nobody there. Well, Patty chips the puck forward. Cassian couldn't stop to pick it up, but Edler controls it center and hammers it around into the Dallas zone. Henrik Sedin onto the ice. He's checked. And the puck played forward. Garbutt's onto it on the left wing. Throws it across. No Stars are there. And Volpatti drops the puck behind the net for Kevin Bieksa. Alex Edler. Henrik Sedin. And now to Bieksa. Volpatti ahead to Bieksa. Smith off the bench. Checked the Vancouver defenseman. The Stars break back, but Henrik Sedin, in support of Bieksa, was able to knock that puck away. Here's Daniel Sedin flipping the puck in and chasing after it. Roby does there for Dallas, tied up by Daniel. Henrik trying to dig the puck free. Daniel's there still. And he gets the puck behind the net, comes up front, jams it on goal, and stopped by Nielstorp in tight. Stars to center. Smith on the right wing. Nice pass in front. Erickson dishes off, and shooting it wide was Brendan Dillon. Erickson again, shot deflected wide of the goal. Looked for a moment like Dillon was going to have a tap in, but it stayed out. It's still 2-1 Stars, and the Canucks have the puck at center. Alex Burrows wants to change, so he sends it in deep. 4.5 minutes into the second period. Canucks trailing by one. That one thrown up the middle and right onto the tape of Jaromír Jágr. Into the Vancouver zone on the right wing, Jágr. Nice move to get around Ballard. Passes back, Rome with the puck. Aaron Rome carries to the corner, centers, and Morrow missed it. Puck deflects all the way down into the Dallas zone. Larson ahead to Morrow, who just missed that puck in front of the Vancouver goal. Garrison lifts it back into Dallas territory, and Morrow is back for the Stars. Leaves in the corner for Larson, ahead for Jágr. Ballard beats him to the puck and flips it the other way. Went out of play momentarily, back onto the ice, and so the whistle blows in the neutral zone.
Brendan Dillon from Louis Erickson, 2-on-0. Puck's rolling, goes off the end of his stick. You wonder what Louis Erickson's thinking here. He's all by himself right in the middle. Let's give it to the defenseman on the side. And the defenseman missed the shot.
Dillon's had a bit of a hot hand, but couldn't put that one in. Said he had Pavel Bure, Jyrki Luumäki memorabilia in his bedroom. Dallas Stars through and through now. Cody Eakin waved out. Ryder moves in to take the draw. And the Stars control inside their own zone. Goligoski for Eakin. And this will be icing as Tanev goes back and beats Antoine Roussel to the puck.
Canucks were really good in the faceoff circle in the first period. They won 10 of 13. Now here's a chance on that icing to win in the offensive zone.
Schrader, Raymond, and Booth remain out. And had a good shift last time out at the offensive end before the Stars turned it the other way. So close to a plus, and you wind up with a minus. Here's Schrader across. Raymond missed the pass. Booth gets it in the corner. Back to the near side for Jordan Schrader. Down comes Edler towards the goal. Raymond Tindall. Booth missed it. He swatted at the puck and just whipped on a chance to put it into the open goal. Raymond comes up with it again on the right wing. Raymond, nice moves. Centers for Schrader. Quick shot blocked. Another chance. Booth tied up, taken down. There'll be a penalty to Aaron Rome. So another good shift at the offensive end for this trio, and it winds up with Aaron Rome heading to the penalty box.
Aaron Rome might get an extra here if he doesn't soon head to the penalty box. And Aaron Rome saying, well, I had his stick on my stick.
Calling it a hook. Booth had that great chance at the side of the goal jump.
Well, Mason Raymond did a nice little tip over to David Booth. I don't think he saw it coming. It went right through his feet. Here's Aaron Rome, and he's got the stick, but then he gets it up into the arms of David Booth, and that's why he's off for hooking.
That was Canucks' second power play. They're 1-for-1 and look pretty efficient in scoring the goal that tied the game at one. But Henrik Sedin took a look and bobbled the puck there. Erik Nyström has it for Dallas. Carries to the Vancouver line. He's poke checked, and the Canucks come back quickly. Henrik Sedin slowly down the left wing. Tried to get it through to Daniel. That was broken up, and Nyström this time slams the puck all the way down. 30 seconds elapsed in the minor penalty to Aaron Rome. Edler drops for Henrik. Here's Ryan Kessler down the right wing. Kessler with a wrist shot, and he'll strike. Couldn't squeeze it, but he made the save. Burrows back to Daniel. Over to Edler. Henrik Sedin on the right wing. Kessler trying to position himself for a one-timer. Here comes the pass, but a penalty coming up to Burrows in front for a cross-check. And that takes Vancouver off the power play.
He and Stefan Robidas were going at it in front of the goal. Burrows in retaliation gives Robidas a push from behind and ends up with the cross-checking penalty. There's the goaltender, gives Burrows a little shot. And Alex doesn't like the call.
Pushed by the netminder and then kind of followed through into Robidas. So the Canucks and Stars will play 4-on-4 for 65 seconds. Schrader and Raymond come out of the 4-on-4. Why not? Showing some good chemistry with the puck here. And here's Bieksa trying to get through to defense. Bieksa backhander scores! What a rush by the red hot Kevin Bieksa, who's got 5 goals in his last 8 games, and he ties it at 2.
Never a bad play. It's a backhand city. Michael Ryder with the backhand, and now Kevin Bieksa on his backhand. Larson is the guy back. Philip Larson and Kevin Bieksa just barely gets 2 hands on the stick to direct this one through. And you can see the goaltender's reaction. You butterfly and you don't have that stick down. Lots of room. Kevin Bieksa finds a space. As you say, when you are red hot, shots like that go in.
He's scoring earlier than we're used to. Normally we're getting accustomed to those late dramatic goals. This one again pulls the Canucks onto even terms. 40 seconds to go on the Rome penalty. And then the Stars will go on to a power play for just under a minute. Hamies was tied up, allowing Dallas to take the puck away, but the X is there to help out his defense partner. And Daniel Sedin takes a hit to make a play to Hamies. Hamies takes his time before backhanding the puck in. Canucks will change with 15 seconds to go in the 4-on-4. Here's Alex Goligoski rushing the puck in with a pass to Derek Roy. His shot gloved by Schneider, who hangs on for the whistle. Twice the Canucks have fallen behind. Twice they've come back. Kevin Bieksa, the latest goal. It's 2-2 here in Big D.
One of the reasons that Canucks are always in the top of the league in scoring is their defensemen get involved. They have the green light. And here's the read. One pass. Now Kevin Bieksa is at full speed. It's Dan Hamies who's bringing the puck out. And Kevin Bieksa is at full speed. Perfect pass. And now Larson. He's kind of flat-footed and Kevin Bieksa is by him.
And that means another winner on Safeway Score and Win for Safeway and Quaker Chewy Bars from Surrey. Dan Gerlach, congratulations. He won an HP MBX2. As they drop the puck, Tanev clears it ahead, and out of the box steps Aaron Rome. So Dallas is on to its third power play for the next 50 seconds. Louis Erickson controls in his own zone, passes back for Robida, who's pressured by Chris Higgins. Robida tries again. Drops for Roy. Now to Erickson. Throws the puck across, intercepted nicely by Max Lapierre, who tips it down on the backhand. Jordan Schrader drew the second assist on Bieksa's fifth. 15 seconds to go in the Dallas power play. Robida passes to the left point. Dillon with a slap shot, and that hit Erickson in front, I think, as he was battling with Keith Ballard. Dillon again. Back for Roy. Brendan Dillon lets it go. A blocker save for Schneider. Roy on the rebound, and Schneider got a piece of that. Burrows is out of the box. Stars with a couple of late chances, but they're 0-for-3 on the power play. Icing the call on that one. The faceoff will come back down into the Vancouver zone.
Play sports action, odds set to outcome. Just pick a winner at bclc.com/sportsaction.
Now, after the icing, you wonder about that little flip pass. Alex Burrows was open, probably could have gained the red line and dumped it in.
Garrison and Yager both jump. And they're going to blame Yager and kick Jamie Benn out of the faceoff circle. On the second attempt, the puck comes free to Burrows, who does skate through center before dumping the puck in deep. He'll stay on the ice and hustle after the puck as the Sedins jump over the boards to join him.
Whoa, man.
Went hard into the Vancouver bench.
Jamie Hendricks was the closest one to it, and the old goalie in him. He was ducking right away.
They'll have smiles now, and so does Aaron Rome, because he almost had what you would have been friendly fire in the old days.
And there it is. And look at Jamie. He is the first one down. Newell Brown is out of the way. Jamie's looking up at the jumbotron to see if it was close.
It's a good thing Aaron was a popular teammate.
Yes.
Henrik Sedin trying to move in. Eriksson winds up with the puck and passes back to Dillon, who finds Robida. Ahead for Eriksson, who deflects the puck with one hand into the corner. Puck comes in front of Schneider, literally knocked that one away, and the Canucks break out to center. Burrows leading the way, Tanev joins him, but forcing the issue was Dillon, who then hit Burrows after the whistle. Brendan Dillon, who played a very edgy game at Rogers Arena on Friday, finished his check there. Murph.
Tell everyone out there that tonight's game between the Canucks and Stars. Safeway's featured participating product for the game is Quaker Chewy Bars.
Well, Aaron Volpatti came off the bench on the line change and went right to Dillon and said, okay, we've got your number. I like that. I like that. After that hit, late hit after the whistle.
Here we got a fight. Cassian and Roussel have dropped the gloves. Zach Cassian letting loose with lefts. Has his helmet popped up. They're not holding back, and down they go, and back up again. Cassian has Roussel in some trouble, and the linesmen get in. So it wasn't Volpatti, it was number 9 with Roussel, who was the most willing combatant.
As you say, Zach Cassian had the helmet pop up, but he was throwing lefts, and he had the sweater over Roussel's head. Now here's the start, and you can see Roussel is going right after Cassian.
Roussel trying to gain the upper hand with that furious start, but he wound up getting the worst of it at the end. So, who's on the ice now? Because these teams like to go at it face-off after face-off, don't they? Well,
no.
Not this time. 5 each for fighting. 5 minutes each for fighting. And Aaron Volpatti chasing after the puck at the Dallas line, steals it away from Larson, offside they sit. Whistle blows, they'll face off outside the Dallas line in a game all even again, the Canucks and the Stars for the second time in a week.
Check the spelling on Nielstorp, that's not the way they spell it back in Sweden, but somehow the H, N-I-H-L-S-T-O-R-P, was left off his passport. So what's on the contract has to be what's on the passport, and what's on the jersey has to be what's on the contract. So there's an H missing. Not the first time this happened here in Dallas. Remember, Nick Grossman had one N on his jersey here, two now in Philly.
Attention to detail, John.
Yes.
Puck out of play at the Dallas bench, and this time it was the backup Richard Bachman who had a puck coming towards him, and he'll flip that one as a souvenir. I'll get some help from the trainer, I guess.
There he goes. One happy fan. Ooh, with the Mike Ribeiro sweater on.
Old school. Recent old school.
Cody Eakin hasn't been as prominent in this game. He played a good game on Friday in Vancouver. He came over from Mike Ribeiro in that trade.
Had some nice things to say about Bruce Boudreau in his days as a Washington Capital. Dan Hamius lets go with a shot wide of the goal. Jamie Benn picks up the loose puck. Here's Cody Eakin. Angled off. And the Canucks take the puck away. Booth moves it out to center. Ben again. And Hamhuis has the puck for the Canucks. Round for Booth. Couldn't get it by Goligoski. Bieksa. Round for Raymond. Fiddler checking him from behind. Steals the puck. Tried to send it in front for Jamie Benn. Raymond took it back, and here's Dan Hamhuis. Good. Flips the puck in. Brendan Dillon collects for the Dallas Stars. Be here. Pretty good crowd here at American Airlines Center, particularly for a Thursday night. Seeing a decent hockey game, too. 2-2 tie. Pretty good pace between the Canucks and the Stars. Here's a long shot from a sharp angle that deflects what? Rovida tries his luck from the other side, and that one's way over the glass for a whistle.
What is this, a switchblade?
I only use it on myself.
Now the Vena birth control pills. You should remember to take these.
I'll take them later.
I think you should take them now.
It's the talk of the continent. City's new comedy, Seed, part of Monday's blockbuster comedy night. The most watched night of the week.
Got great reviews. TV critics.
Does that include you?
I haven't seen it yet.
Oh, okay. Because you always are willing to express your opinion.
Yes.
Stars setting it up in the Vancouver zone. Larson with a shot tipped away by Garrison. And the puck goes high and not out of play. Comes down in the corner. Garrison tips it ahead for Higgins. He's checked by Roy. Garrison again can't get it by Roy. Stars try to get it in front to Erickson. And finally, Higgins able to move the puck to Dale Weiss. On the left wing, Higgins gives chase. Larson over to check in. Pass for Weiss broken up. Roy turns with the puck deep in his own zone. Can't get it by Higgins. In front for Kessler, but the pass was behind him, and the puck comes out to neutral ice. Jordy Benn sends it ahead. Tipped in by Morrow. Stars dump it around to the near side. Higgins for Vancouver. End of his shift, trying to work the puck into the Dallas zone. Jágr takes it away and passes ahead to Brendan Morrow. Into the middle for Jamie Benn. Bieksa broke that up. Jágr cruising up the middle. Now here's Morrow on the back end. Benn!
Oh, what a stop!
Saved by Schneider. Here's Dylan Schneider stopping him. Jágr in the rebound, backhanded it wide. Edler's lost his stick. Frantic action in the Vancouver zone, and Ben's shot is off a stick and over the glass after Corey Schneider made two huge stops point blank.
And you can see Jamie Benn shaking his head. The advantage of being 6'3 and having the long legs, Corey Schneider is able to drag that left leg in tight, pulled to the backhand, and look at that save there. Wow. Jamie Benn was shaking his head. He thought that was in for short.
Edler helping out late on the Jágr chance as well.
Still shaking his head. Sitting on the bench.
Here's Erickson. Stars trying to keep up the momentum after that shift. Schneider hasn't faced nearly the number of quality opportunities in this one as he did in Chicago, but a couple of huge stops there to keep it 2-2. Daniel Sedin for Vancouver. Up to Kevin Bieksa, who backhands the puck into the Dallas zone. Daniel pokes it free to Henrik. Pass for Ballard, but he moved in from the blue line. Hanhuis over to hold the puck in the zone. Dumps it around for Burrows. Now to Daniel Sedin. Robita's on him. Daniel pokes the puck to the far side. Shields his man to allow Henrik to pick up the puck. Now Burrows, poke check by Eakin. Henrik, though, takes control. Henrik does a full 360 before losing the puck to Louis Erickson. Here's Ryder. Pass to Erickson. Sends one on goal, and reaching out to snare that puck was Corey Schneider, who's been busy the last few shifts. Under 6 minutes to go in the second, and deuces are wild here in Dallas.
Think you know the answer to questions like, will the Canucks score first, or how many penalties in the game? Then join the Last Fan Standing every game night for your chance to win weekly Canucks prizes. Also earn entries for grand prizes like season tickets or a VIP experience. Go to Canucks.com/Last Fan Standing to play.
It's under 6 minutes to go in the second period. Canucks and Dallas tied at 2. Canucks at it again tomorrow in Nashville. Predators waiting, resting, and watching intently. Tanev knocked down. Stars look to take advantage. Fiddler stripped of the puck by Chris Tanev, who starts out with a pass to Dale Weiss. He tips the puck in. LaPierre gives chase in the corner. Backs up your centers, and Volpatti there couldn't jam it home. Volpatti keeps after the puck in the corner. Comes to Tanev. In deep for LaPierre. LaPierre up the boards for Volpatti. Behind the net, Booth has come onto the ice. David Booth centers. Volpatti tried a wrist shot, couldn't get it through. Larson, oh, hit hard. Volpatti stepped into it. Puck is into the Vancouver zone. Tanev bumped by Nystrom as he gets it ahead and out to center. Larson to Benn. Jordy Benn wrists the puck into Vancouver territory. Edler for Volpatti, out of his reach. Held in by Goligoski. Long shot through traffic. Schneider tracked it and held on.
Aaron Volpatti. Skates by Aaron Rome. Tries to hit Philip Larson. Larson sees him at the last second. Stops, gets back out of the way. And now how late is this one? I guess it's all right. He's got the arm up.
Yeah, the left-hand follow-through a little more troublesome than the timing. Here's Tanev, just always bounces right back up. And he should be X out for this defensive zone draw. Schrader against Jamie Benn. And Benn complaining as he thought he was tripped up by Schrader. Canucks able to clear the zone. Schrader intercepts at center. Raymond tips the puck in, chases in on Goligoski. Raymond forces the puck behind the net. Booth is after it for Vancouver. Jágr comes back. Goligoski from behind the net. Raymond fell down trying to flush him out. Goligoski banks the puck ahead for Jágr. Try to play it in the middle. Good positioning for Schrader. Now to Bieksa. And he flips the puck free to David Booth. He's checked, but Schrader follows on and forces the puck to the Dallas line before being tripped up himself. Here's Goligoski into the Vancouver zone. Ben poke checked, and Schrader clears the puck to neutral ice. Aaron Rome is there, wristing it in. Schneider out of his net, leaves the puck behind the net for Bieksa. Just about 3.5 minutes to go in the second. Canucks 2 and Dallas 2. Dan Hamhuis. Cross corner dump. Dillon is back up the boards for Smith. Riley Smith plays the puck to the near side. Onto it is Derek Roy. Slows, can't get around Jason Garrison. Higgins trying to catch up with the puck, couldn't do it. Stays in the Vancouver zone. Kessel trying to muscle it out. Higgins as well. Garrison's there. But it comes in the middle of Erickson. Steps wide on Ballard. Puts it in front. Oh, that just grazed the outside of the post as Roy was cutting the net, hoping to tip it in. Now Zach Cassian plays chip and charge on Dillon, who gets to the puck first. Gives it away to Kessler, but he overskated the puck in the corner. Riley Smith starts back with a pass to Louis Erickson. That was out of the reach of Roy. And the puck banked around for Garrison, who has to try to catch up. He pokes at the puck, but can't get it out. Ballard has a chance and goes up the boards to Henrik Sedin. Henrik for Burrows. Cutting it on goal. Burrows deeks. Nilstrup the save. He covers up. No, he doesn't. Henrik's jamming at it, and Nilstrup now has the puck after Burrows turned on the Jets, cutting it off the right wing.
And what a perfect pass by Henrik Sedin, the feather pass, and you can see Alex Burrows thought he should have been able to do a little more with it. Burrows gets his pass. He's on his backhand. He's in tight. It has his stick chopped at the last second. Pass. And at the last second, Alex Burrows has his stick hooked and can't direct it towards the net.
Aaron Rome on the defensive play. Henrik Sedin to take the draw against Cody Eakin. Puck comes to Daniel along the boards. Ties up Goligoski. Burrows gets the puck. Burrows again. Nice pass in close quarters to Daniel. Daniel centers. Henrik took a swipe of the puck, couldn't make contact. Burrows to Daniel behind the goal, kicks the puck to Henrik. Henrik Sedin working on Eakin. Penalty coming up to Eakin as he grabbed a hold of Henrik. Schneider to the bench for the extra attacker. Now they blow it down. And with 2:05 to go in the second period, the Canucks get a power play and a chance to take their first lead. Before we talk about that more, here's Murph.
Guys, Canucks, of course, in Nashville tomorrow, but after that's game done, do not change the channel. Friday Night Hockey, J.C. LaPonne and the Blazers taking on Brett Kulak and the Vancouver Giants.
Cody Eakin gets behind Henrik Sedin, and he just, because he's smaller, doesn't have position, he grabs a sweater. And you can see right there, he's got the sweater, the wide receiver. Pull the guy back, and Cody Eakin ends up with a holding penalty. Your defensive back and that wide receiver has position. Yes. You reach out and you grab his sweater. That's just what he did.
All right. Did I look confused?
Yes, you did.
Here's Hendrickson. Third power play for the Canucks. They're 1-for-2. Daniel to Kessler. Tried to send it across. That was blocked. Ryan Kessler gets the puck again. Quickly back to Daniel Sedin. Down for Kessler. Turns to get away from Nystrom. Kessler. Pass back for Edler. That's off the mark. And the puck's in the center ice area. Edler carries it back. Fiddler closes the gap. Edler fell down. Henrik Sedin is back to help out. 30 seconds elapsed in the penalty to Eakin. As Daniel steps in on the left wing. Daniel still with the puck. Back to Edler. Pass for Daniel. Just got through. He rings the puck around for Henrik. The quarterback on the right wing. Nice pass to Burrows. Under pressure, loses the puck, but Edler's there to hold it onside. Henrik Sedin reached back blindly and took the pass perfectly. Into the corner for Daniel. Back up for Henrik. Daniel in front. Kessler, another penalty coming up, but it's against Vancouver, and it's an interference call, I think, again to Burrows.
Last one, he got a cross-checking call when he took down Stefan Robida.
Same two hooking up once more.
Here's Dillon and Burrows, and here's Robida and Burrows, and oh man.
He sold it, that's for
he
sure.
He sold it.
But what do the coaches say? Don't put yourself in position
that's
for
right.
the officials to make a decision. And that was kind of the old Bertuzzi push-off. Made famous on power plays many moons ago. So it's 4-on-4 again. And Rome has the puck in the Vancouver zone. Roussel for Jamie Benn. Back to Rome. Moves to the middle. He shoots Schneider. Juggled it. Schrader there. Tried to throw it up the middle. Blocked by Benn. Here's Goligoski. To Jaromír Jágr. Hamu's trying to stay with him. And the Exa blocked the centering pass. Goligoski the drive. And a stick save by Corey Schneider. Raymond gets the loose puck. 25 seconds to go in the period. He finds Schrader, who dashes in on the left wing. Jordan Schrader looks back for help. Now finds Raymond in the corner, but the pass eludes him. Raymond ties up his man in the corner. 12 seconds to go in the period. And Goligoski picks up the loose puck. Jágr gets it out. And that'll do it for period number two as Bieksa picks up the loose puck. Kevin Bieksa had one of the goals in the second period as the team's traded tallies. Ryder for Dallas, Bieksa for the Canucks, and Corey Schneider made some key saves late. 2-2 through 2. Stay tuned on our second intermission. The panel will talk about the Yannick Hansen suspension and Brian Burke scouting for Anaheim. And we'll hear from Trevor Linden as he discusses the Sedin brothers. We're through 2 in Dallas. It's the Canucks 2 and the Stars 2.
Take a look at the scoring summaries. They're brought to you by Panago. Before, during, or after the game, get a fresh Panago. Didn't take long for the Stars to open the scoring. JB Benn with his fifth of the season, just 35 seconds in. Alex Burrows on the power play tied it up with his fifth. In the second, Ryder gave the Stars another one-goal lead before Kevin Bieksa replied with his fifth. 2-2 is your score.
John Garrett, with your expert analysis, take us through the scoring in this hockey game, would you please?
Well, the Canucks got off to a bad start the first shift, and it was nothing but pressure. Jágr had a chance before Jamie Benn had this chance, and right on the goal line, right underneath the bar, he beats Corey Schneider over the shoulder, short side. And then Alex Burrows, a long wrist shot, kicks this one by Nils Thorpe. Off the post and in, you could hear it. Good tip in by Alex Burrows, and then in the second period, a fluky bounce goes right to Michael Ryder, and on the backhand, he beats Corey Schneider as Keith Ballard provided the screen on that one. And then a beautiful pass by Dan Hamhuis to Kevin Bieksa, and he slips one by Nils Thorpe. one that I'm sure Nilsdorf would like to have back, but a good play nonetheless.
Captain Henrik Sedin, we heard Trevor Linden waxing eloquent about the brothers, and you talked about them maybe having slow starts and weren't playing and certainly picking it up of late.
Well, 12 points in the last three games, Daniel and Henrik. They haven't got any here tonight, but they have been much better in the past week to 10 days.
Stars are on a power play for about a minute to begin period number three. Alex Burrows is off, serving the remainder of his interference mark. Dallas 0-3 on the power play in the hockey game. Bieksa retrieves his stick as Hanhuis collects the puck, but didn't get much on the clearing attempt. Here's Morrow in front off a pass from Yager, and then on the rebound, Ben shot wide. Hanhuis, another weak clearing attempt. That one just held in by Jordy Bent, but Hanhuis, third time lucky, gets the puck to center. Here's Jamie Benn moving back in. Passes to Yager. Yager down the right side. Lapierre knocked the puck away. Jamie Benn gets it back to Robida. Here's Jordy Benn. Wrist shot blocked by Bieksa. Jamie Benn tried to center. That was blocked as well. He plays the puck to the far side for Yager. 10 seconds to go in the Dallas power play. Yager, the right wing hash marks. Down to Benn. Jamie Benn up to Yager. In front for Morrow. Couldn't make contact. Jordy Benn at the left point. Carries down the boards. Benn to Yager. To Jamie Benn. He shoots Schneider off a tip puck stop. Did that hurt Hanhuis? The left hand, I think. He partially blocked it, and then Schneider made the save. But the concern right now is the native of Smithers, Dan Hanhuis.
Mike Bernstein started to come off the bench, but now Dan Hanhuis. He was knocked down in front, and I think he was thinking, okay, it's the same thing as Stefan Robida when he got knocked down by Alex Burrows. And you can see he's got the glove off. Dan Hanhuis is down. And with the left hand, a goaltender style, right off the end of the fingers.
It's really still laboring at the bench, as you can see. And hopefully, as they say in sport, it's more pain than injury, and it'll subside and allow him to continue. But you worry about the simple act of gripping the stick at the moment. Daniel Sedin ices the puck. Canucks are back to full strength, so this will draw a whistle, and the faceoff will come back into Vancouver territory.
Well, you get that ice bag on it as fast as you can and try and get the swelling from not setting in so you can grip your stick.
Kessler on this draw against Derek Roy. And he wins it to the corner. Edler tied up by Erickson. Tanev comes in to tie up a Dallas player. Puck comes to Roy. Saucers back to the blue line, but it's past Robida and out. Erickson up to Riley Smith. Drag move, and the puck knocked away by Tanev. Burrows battling for the puck along the boards. Does well to shield it momentarily, but the Stars set it up in front for a shot by Erickson. Where'd it go? Nobody seemed to see it, but it went high and out of play for a whistle.
Alex Edler able to get his stick on that one. Now here's Edler. Stay in position, stay in the middle, stay in the middle, and he's able to reach out, use that long reach, and tip it up and over the glass.
Dan Hanhuis still with the left hand. He had the ice bag on. He and Bieksa are not sitting beside each other. Does that indicate he's going to miss his next shift? Or
I don't know. He was gripping there, and you can see Mike Bernstein passing the gloves back.
Kevin took a look there, said he okay to go next shift. Rick Bonus would be the man to juggle him up. As they drop the puck into Vancouver in, and Kessler's onto it to Zach Cassian. Chips it in for Higgins to move in on Goligoski. Ryder back for the puck for Dallas. And ahead to Cody Eakin. Roussel zigged when Eakin expected him to zag. And here's Higgins the other way. Into the middle. Kessler shoots high and wide. Good look there for Ryan Kessler. Now he sends one to the crease. That deflects back to Garrison, who shoots. And that was blocked by a sprawling Roussel. That hurt Roussel. He's slow to get up. Garrison again scores! Roussel was struggling to the bench. He's still down on all fours as the Canucks celebrate a go-ahead goal.
Now, is this one tipped?
And this is good pressure right from the Ryan Kessler shot. And Chris Higgins was the guy in front. Here's the shot Garrison takes, and Russell is down in awkward position. Chris Higgins looks like Alex Burrows on this one.
Certainly waved at it.
He did wave at it. He had a good look at it. Garrison's shot comes through. I think he got it.
I'm not going to argue with you tonight, partner.
Yeah, I think he got it. I think that's going to be Chris Higgins' goal.
Russell at the bench. She's the one laboring now. And the Stars, for the first time in a hockey game, are on the trailing end. Here is Hamhuis, who's back out there. Nice pass to Schrader. Tried to shovel to Bieksa, but the pass came out to center. So Hamhuis doesn't miss a shift. After the road hockey shot block that felled him his last time out. Now he's in a race for the puck. Look out! Oh! He got there. And Garbutt having words for the Bieksa. You can hear the official saying no contact.
Yeah, but how about the stick? See, it doesn't have to be. Kevin Bieksa is saying, well, how about the stick?
Fans on your way home tonight, check out the
official. That's Johnny Bear, the referee, in conversation with Kevin Bieksa. And Dan Hamhuis is all right. He kind of hit the board sideways rather than fully feet first.
That's after the game, only on Sports Radio.
Sure, his hand is hurting worse than his legs after the shot block.
2:32, the time of the go-ahead goal for the Canucks. And a fourth line shift for Vancouver with a face-off deep in the Dallas zone. Jordy Benn starts from behind the goal. Out to center. Edler turns that the other way. Stars force the puck into the Vancouver zone. Tanev has it, looking up ice. Pass to Volpatti, who stumbled. Tanev couldn't come up with the puck. Schrader, Lapierre tips it back, and Tanev passes over to Alex Edler. Ahead for Aaron Volpatti, who tips the puck in. Larson makes a move to the near side and frees up the puck for Jordy Benn out to center. Fiddler plays it to the far side. Stars changing in the neutral zone as Edler eludes a check, and the puck comes free to Tanev. Garrison is getting credit for the goal for the moment. With Kessler and Cassian drawing the assists, so a couple of helpers for Ryan Kessler in the hockey game. Here comes Jamie Benn. In over the Vancouver line. Morrow, Jágr, Benn! And I'm not sure the shot got through. Jágr, back to Goligoski. Down for Jaromír Jágr. Sends one to the near corner. That ricochets to Daniel Sedin, who takes a look and gets the puck out. It's past Rome, and Henrik in with Burrows. Henrik Sedin centers. Burrows to Henrik. He scores!
Oh, man, was that nice.
Give and go, back and forth. Two-goal lead for Vancouver.
You would think Aaron Rome would know better. Don't pinch in when the Sedins are on the ice. And Aaron Rome gets caught at center ice. He tries to pick the puck off with his stick. It gets by him, and that creates a two-on-one. And we saw this before on Henrik's record-setting night against Dallas, the give-and-go with Alex Burrow. Everybody thinks Alex is going to shoot. Aaron Rome tries to get back. Look where the goaltender ends up. There's Aaron Rome trying to stand up. And now it's a two-on-one. And look at the goaltender. Whoa, baby. Your third start in the NHL. Haven't seen that one very often.
Two goals in a minute 46. And the Canucks, who hadn't led until that point, are up by two. Here's Riley Smith for Dallas. Louis Erickson to the blue line. Robida, long shot, that deflected, and Schneider had to make a nice stop. Now another shot by Dillon coming in off the point, and that went wide.
Vancouver goal scored by number 33.
Kessler sends the puck forward. This will be icing as Dillon goes back to get the whistle.
22, Daniel Sedin. Time the goal for 18.
Well, under 2 minutes apart, the Canucks score twice.
Now the first one, Jason Garrison takes the shot, and here's Chris Higgins. He waves at it. I think he got a piece of it and steers it wide. And here's Aaron Rome trying to stand up, trying to pick that pass off. Now it's a two-on-one. Henrik to Alex Burrows, right back to Henrik. And look at those passes. Talk about precise. Just out of the reach, just under the stick. And
making the goaltender look bad with the give and give.
Assuming it stays Garrison's, it's the second of the season for both him and Henry. Jordy Benn from behind his own net. Raymond trying to chase him from behind. Benn carries to center. Flips the puck forward, and that one goes out of play. They'll face off in the neutral zone.
You know when there was bonuses before the last CBA?
Yes.
Then the guys would, I got it. They'd be pointing at their chest. But then the CBA, they came up with the rule, well, okay, there was no individual bonuses anymore. And so the guys tipping the puck in front of the net, it's no big deal. If the defenseman gets the goal, who cares?
Well, if it's contract year, maybe. But I hear you. It's good for team building.
It is.
Dan Hamhuis still, despite staying in the game, is seeking treatment in between shifts. David Booth to Alex Edler. Raymond back for Edler. Slap shot. Stick broke. They'll have one ready for him as he hustles back to the neutral zone, but he's not going to have time to pick it up. Tanev broke up the play as Ryder was busting down the right wing. Edler still without his stick. Forwards haven't handed him one. And he's trying to battle Jamie Benn in front of the goal. Now Booth comes back and hands him his stick. Long shot, stopped by Schneider, who wisely angled the stick and turned it over the glass. John Garrett knows a smart play when he sees one. It's 4-2 Vancouver here in the third.
Jason Garrison, big shot on his goal. And from this angle, I don't know whether Chris Higgins got it or not. It might have gone up a little bit, and he's reacts like he got it.
We'll give it to Garrison, and we'll give Husqvarna Trimmer to Kathy Roney of Victoria, courtesy Safeway and Quaker Chewy Bars on Score and Win.
Another face-off win. The Canucks have done a good job.
Look out, a turnover and a goal by Morrow as Kessler overskated the puck. And Brendan Morrow, the Dallas captain, was Johnny on the spot to make it a one-goal game.
Ryan Kessler, instead of getting that puck out of danger, decided to carry it out of danger. Ryan Kessler in the faceoff gets some help from Chris Higgins, wins the draw. Now the puck, look at the room he's got. Instead of just moving the puck, he tries to carry it. It's rolling a little bit, overskates it, and Brendan Morrow's there to fire it home.
So, lots of time left in a one-goal game again. With the momentum the Canucks had built up, quickly quelled. Still with a one-goal advantage, and Schneider to play this puck to Alex Edler. Erickson flushes him out. Edler gets the puck ahead to Burrows, who backhands it forward. Daniel Sedin's after it, checked by Stefan Robida. Roy missed the pass at center. Tanev has the puck ahead for Henrik. Forced back by Smith, who's chasing after the puck, and Edler gets there first. Tanev took a look, missed it momentarily. Now reverses for Henrik Sedin. Edler takes the outlet pass, finds Daniel right wing at center. He wants off on a change, so he banks the puck in behind the goal. New life here at American Airlines Center as we hit the 7-minute mark, third period. Ryan Garbutt swings the puck out, driven back in by Bieksa, trying to catch the goaltender napping, and Nilstorp made a right pad save. Stars ice the puck. Fiddler giving chase, however, and whoa. Tried to lift the stick of Bieksa. They'll have words.
Fans with Brendan Morrow's goal.
Maybe Kevin can do his Vern Fiddler imitation.
Yes. Now here's Henrik, gives it to Alex Burrows. And look at Goligoski. He turns right around. The goaltender turns right around. And Henrik puts it in.
And by swiping a free club card, Theodora Saunders of White Rock from Safeway and Quaker Chewy Bars has won a Ligostina 11-piece cookware set.
Boy, you're the defenseman and you let that pass go across. You're naturally going to react to it, thinking that the guy's going to shoot.
Face off after the icing to the right of Nilstorp. Stars have outshot the Canucks 23-19. The Vancouver, the 4-3 lead. Bieksa hits the side of the net with that test. Puck center. Well, Patty couldn't jam it home. Keeps after the puck in the corner. Tied up by Robida. And Garbin is able to chip it out to center. Cam Hughes advanced it. Whoa. Weiss had Fiddler lined up. Bieksa bumped in the corner. Lapierre's onto the puck. Three Canucks to center. Lapierre in. Banks the puck to the corner. Moves in on Larson and rides him into the end boards. Well, Patty was after the puck as well, but the Stars come up with it. Canucks will change as Larson skates the puck to center. 8 minutes into the third. Garrison chips the puck free for David Booth. Nice pass to Jordan Schrader, who relays to Mason Raymond. Schrader going to the net. Raymond center. Schrader had his stick lifted. That was Jordy Benn with the defensive play. Here's Ballard. Left point. Garrison with a drive and a stick saved by the goaltender Nielstorp. Jordy Benn in traffic. Able to work the puck free, and it's played out to center. After it is Antoine Roussel, knocked away by Ballard. Roussel tried to send the puck across. That deflects to the near side, and Garrison is there for Vancouver. Henrik Sedin with a neat move to beat two Stars. Lost the puck, following up is Edler. He tripped up his man after losing the puck, and play goes on. Unpopular non-call. Rome to the far boards. Here's Jágr. Giving chase is Brendan Morrow. Tanev gets the puck the other way to Burrows. His pass blocked. Comes to Edler. Fights off Ben and gets the puck forward. It's scrambling in the neutral zone, and Rome risks the puck in from center ice. Jágr gets it on the right wing. Jágr dumps it to the near side. Morrow for Ben out of his reach, but Jágr gets to the puck on the right wing once more. Jágr goes behind the net. Turning on the left wing. Ben tried to get a shot away. Couldn't. Now it's fired wide. Morrow on the rebound. Couldn't get the puck in front. Jágr has it in the corner. Canucks having some trouble in their own zone. Centering pass for Rome. And a penalty coming up to Dallas as Burrows was hooked. So after the pressure in the Canucks into the ice, the Stars take a penalty. And Brendan Morrow skates to the box.
Well, the fans thought that Alexander should have been called for tripping, and this time Brendan Morrow, there's no doubt about that one, reaches around Alex Burrows and takes the hooking penalty.
Fourth power play for the Canucks. Burrows, who took a couple of penalties with his team on the power play, draws one here after that long shift for the Sedin line. They'll remain on the bench as Schrader comes out with Raymond and Cassian. Cam Hughes and Bieksa are the point men, and Robida with the early clear. Schneider out of his net. Leaves the puck for Dan Hughes. We're halfway through the third period. Canucks leading Dallas 4-3. Nice pass by Cassian to Mason Raymond. Making moves on the right wing. Raymond tried to go rink wide. That was intended for Bieksa, who now tracks the puck down and fires back to Schrader. Down to Bieksa. Into the corner for Zach Cassian. Cassian on the left wing. Back to Bieksa. Here's Hughes. Raymond on the right wing. Goal line feed. Schrader back to Hughes. Can he shoot it with that hand? Let's it go and tick wide. It was a slap pass to Schrader. Just missed. Cassian from behind the net. Shovels the puck to Raymond. In front to Schrader, who stick broke. He'll head to the bench as Bieksa tries to hold the puck in. Checked by Nystrom. Lead pass. Fiddler trying to get around Hughes. Took him down. No call. Canucks still on the power play. Much to the chagrin of this crowd at the American Airlines Center. Kessler on the left side. Edler at the blue line. Right side feed. Henrik Sedin. 40 seconds to go on the power play. Henrik's pass, not a good one. Raymond battles to get the puck back. Works it to Henrik. Now to Daniel. Kessler over top of the net. Hammered the puck, but missed it. Missed the target. Now Daniel for Henrik. One hands the puck behind the goal. Rome gives chase. Burrows is onto the ice. And he fires back to Daniel Sedin. Tried to get it through to Henrik. Stars break that up and clear the zone. With 10 seconds to go on the penalty, number 10, Brendan Morrow. Still no shots for the Canucks, but Kessler had a great look. Henrik kicks the puck to Burrows. Back to Henrik. And one last clear for Dillon. Here's Morrow back onto the ice. Canucks 1-for-4 on the power play, still leading 4-3 with 8 minutes to go. Garrison unloads the puck. Lapierre at center. Check before he got to the Dallas blue line, and here's Jamie Benn. Pass to the side, Jágr couldn't get the shot through. And David Booth is onto the puck for Vancouver. Chips it into the Dallas zone and moves in on Robidoux. Canucks need to be wary here. This place has been none too happy over a couple of non-calls, and fans have made their feelings known. Next one might be blown. Here's Morrow. Center and Goligoski didn't get good wood on the shot. Booth check, couldn't move out. Puck bounced over Jágr's stick, and Lapierre settles it in his own zone with a pass to Chris Tanev. Tanev pulling away from Smith. Turns back. Schrader takes the pass. He pulls away from a couple of attempted checks. Works the puck to Weiss, tried to return it to Jordan Schrader, who goes after the puck in the corner and takes a healthy hit from Philip Larson. 7 minutes to go in the third. Canucks up by one. Goligoski deep in his own zone. Ahead to Smith, who kicked the puck up neatly with his right skate. Nice move. He's around Ballard and tried to throw it in front. That deflected off a sprawling Dan Hamhuis. Weiss trying to get the puck out. He does, and here comes Raymond. Wide on Goligoski, cuts inside, leaves for Schrader, back to Raymond, he shoots, and a nice save by Nilsdorp, sliding to his left. Hangs on to the puck, and gets the whistle. Was this a penalty? They certainly thought so here in Dallas, as Vern Fiddler couldn't get around Hamhuis.
There is nothing like being there. Tickets still available for all home games, including this Tuesday, February 26th at 7 o'clock when the Canucks take on the Phoenix Coyotes. Experience the excitement of seeing the Canucks play live at Rogers Arena. Go to Canucks.com/tickets today.
Dallas chapter of the John Garrett Fan Club.
Yes, they're ready. They're ready. Mardi Gras was, what, 2 weeks ago?
It's always Mardi Gras in your life, isn't it?
Yes.
Canucks break up the attempted entry by the Stars of their own line. This will be icing as Dillon got to the puck first. On the whistle, here's Murph.
Guys, tonight Safeway's $1 million score and win grand prize winner will receive an all-inclusive trip for two to Puerto Vallarta, Mexico, courtesy of redtag.ca. Tonight's winner is Marjorie Helland of Victoria. Congratulations.
Probably a Canuck fan, probably a Ben fan as well. You can have your cake and eat it too if you live on the island.
Ah, there's Henrik Sedin, who's had a tough night in the faceoff, win that one cleanly.
Puck comes to him, he cuts in front. We saw that a few moments ago off a faceoff, went wound up in the net. Canucks have four to center and a chance to break into the Dallas zone. Oh,
wow.
Daniel in by a hair ahead of Alex Edler, says Derek Amell.
And the Canucks don't complain too much about it. It was very close. I thought Adler stretched ahead. Here's Daniel. He's ahead of the play, but look at Adler right here.
What? They're usually right.
Yes, they are usually right.
Although the focus of the week hasn't been on that, they are usually right.
And Derek Amell has had a tough week so far.
Are we piling on at this point?
No.
What's your favorite expression? Be nice.
Be nice.
Here's Jágr. Pass ahead, Jamie Benn. Back for Jágr. Quick shot. Schneider had to be sharp on that one as Jágr, mid-stride, let go with a test on the Vancouver goal. And the clear is just enough for icing, which means we have time to talk to Murph again.
Guys, spring training, Grapefruit League action. The Blue Jays on Sportsnet, Toronto versus Detroit this Saturday, 9:30 a.m. Pacific time.
Another face-off in the Vancouver zone, Kessler against Jamie Benn. And puck not dropped fairly, they're gonna wave Benn out. He'll complain while getting an explanation from Matt McPherson. Pucky skates, squirts free to Chris Higgins. And he backhands it out to center. Jágr has possession there with just over 5.5 minutes to go in the third. Canucks in a one-goal lead. Aaron Rome up for Jaromír Jágr. His pass picked off by Raymond. Oh, Jágr reached out as Raymond made a nice move. Couldn't catch up with the puck. And Goligoski comes back, playing the puck into Vancouver zone and hustling in behind Bieksa. He's going to get a penalty. Bieksa reached out. And as Hanhuis picks up the puck, the whistle blows for an interference call. Bieksa tried to knock the puck out of the air, and Goligoski skated by him. Kevin reached out, he'll head off, and the Stars with a chance to tie the game and return to Dallas. It's a power play, their fifth of the night. Stars on the power put. Kevin Bieksa in the box. Dallas trailing by a goal. Derek Roy trying to bring the puck out front. It's loose behind the net. Erickson into the corner for Ryder. Back to Jordy Bent. To the side of the net for Erickson. Broken up by Garrison, who gets the puck in the corner. Shovels it up to Ryan Kessler, who takes a look and clears the puck all the way down.
This is the best game Jason Garrison's played in a while. Playing with Keith Ballard.
Minute 25 to go on the minor penalty to Kevin Bieksa. As Erickson rushes the puck in. Works it to Ryder. He's checked by Higgins, who's working feverishly to get the puck out, but can't do it. Lapierre knocks it back deep in his own zone. Tanev gets to the puck. Sends it near side. Jordy Benn read that one. Into the corner, Erickson. Tanev puts a hip into him, and that allows the puck to be sent around, only to be held into the right point by Goligoski. Ryder checked by Higgins. Doing some good work, shorthanded, and he forces the puck out to center. Lapierre tips it to the Dallas blue line, and the Canucks are changing as he keeps an eye on Jordy Benn. Still no shots for the Stars with this man advantage. 45 seconds to go on the penalty. Just under 4 minutes left in the third period. Benn plays chip and charge. Tips the puck behind the net. Edler picks it off. Works it to the corner, but no further. Here's Jamie Benn. Blue line feed. Robida, slap shot, and that goes off Edler and wide. Jordy Benn sends it across. Deflects back to Robida. Down to Jágr. Jaromír Jágr to Jamie Benn. Dishes off. Jordy Benn. Jamie Benn. And diving out were a couple of Canucks to tip the puck out of play as Edler and Weiss combined on the defensive play.
Well, that was a good read as the Dallas Stars tried to go back door. Jason Garrison in front with Brandon Morrow, and there's the pass across, and you can see, as you said, John, both players, Alex Edler and Dale Weiss, in position to tip that one up and over the glass.
Wonder if they worked on that play in the driveway. Trying to set it up in front. Puck escapes Robidon up to center. Stars have 10 seconds left in the power play. Brendan Dillon dumps the puck around. Hanhuis sends it. Off Robidon, sticking up to center. Bieksa is out of the box and he's after the puck at center ice. Sends it deep into the Dallas zone with 3 minutes to go in the third. Jágr blows a tire at center but gets back up with the puck. Dumps it in as he's bumped by Zach Cassian. Cassian just inside his own line. Good high percentage play to tip the puck down to the Dallas blue line. Larson. Ahead for Ryder. They say he got a piece of it. Garrison reverses nicely to Ballard. Here's Mason Raymond. Rink wide for Garrison, who's in on the right side. But Zach Cassian had both feet inside the blue line, and it's an offside whistle. Perfect.
Well, Canucks fans, before the game tomorrow, make sure to tune in to Canucks TV this week. 4 o'clock Friday night, Kessler, male model. Nolan Baumgartner from player to coach, and Pavel selected to the Hockey Hall of Fame.
Interesting to see the feature on Nolan Baumgartner. He was almost an assistant coach the last couple of years that he played in Winnipeg. And he moved to Chicago. Really helped a lot of the younger players along as the captain of that team.
Here's David Booth from the left wing. Wrist shot held onto by Nilsdorf. 2 minutes, 17 seconds. How many seconds is that, John?
137.
Very well done.
You'd be sitting there in the net counting it down.
Don't forget to stay tuned. Don Taylor, Gary Ball will get you connected. Wild and Oilers are playing as we speak as well. They'll have highlights from that game. Another Northwest battle. This is Northwest versus Central, and the Canucks with a one-goal lead, versus Pacific. And here's Booth breaking in on goal. David Booth fired it wide. There's going to be at least a penalty on the play as he was interfered with cutting in. And it is just a hooking call. But David Booth, with his speed and size, able to help draw a penalty against Dallas.
With 2:01 left in a one-goal game, penalty is almost better.
Derek Roy gets the gate.
Reached with one hand, and they finally let his stick go. It's right in the midsection of David Booth. He misses the net by quite a bit because he was hooked from behind.
I'm a man, Peter. I've got an ocean of testosterone flowing through my veins.
Fifth power play for the Canucks. They're 1-for-4. Interestingly, they elect to stay with Daniel Sedin on the left point. And he has the puck. Down to Kessler, who's checked. Stars may try to get it to 5-on-5, at the very least, if they can move the puck up the ice and try to get the goalie to the bench. Minute 45 to go. Kessler tracks the puck on the left wing, in deep for Burrows, and around to Henrik Sedin. Henrik back to Edler. Ryan Kessler takes the pass. Throws one in front, that deflects to Henrik Sedin. 90 seconds left in the third period. Henrik content to just hang on to the puck. Stars may have to force the issue. Time running out, minute 20 to go. Henrik back to Edler. Henrik again. Cross to Daniel. Slap shot, tipped wide. Kessler chips the puck free to Henrik in the corner. If the Stars had designs on getting the goalie to the bench, they haven't been able to come up with the puck. Canucks playing keep away. Minute to go. Vancouver leading by one. Henrik Sedin in deep. Kessler from the left wing corner. Reverses for Henrik. Edler at the blue line. Takes a look. Doesn't shoot it. Daniel Sedin. 40 seconds to go. Kessler back to Daniel. Edler at the right point. And the Stars are too tired to pressure now, it would appear. Daniel. Kessler. And a weak shot wide. Henrik Sedin, 30 seconds to go. Burrows lets the puck go through to Kessler. Tried to set up Daniel coming off the left point. Pass didn't get through.
This is unbelievable.
Stars just can't get the puck.
No.
15 seconds left.
Give it back to Henrik. There you go.
What is time of possession has been on this power play?
Give it back to Henrik again.
5 seconds left, and the Canucks just run out the clock. The three-game winless streak is over. One last shot on Schneider on the horn, and the Canucks with a winning goal from their captain, Henrik Sedin. A ragging of the puck on the power play, and Alain Vigneault's team is 1-1, or 1-0-1, I should say, on this road trip.
And Corey Schneider, after a shaky start, that goal from almost the goal line in the first minute of play settled down, and he made, as you said, John, that second period, made two or three great saves to keep the score close, and then the Canucks just kept coming back.
One in particular off Jamie Benn, who was the player who scored that early goal, but Garrison and Henrik Sedin with third period tallies, and Henrik winds up with the winner as the Canucks celebrate the victory, but no rest for the weary. They're off to Nashville, and we'll see you from the Music City tomorrow.